Ah, space, the final frontier. It's a vast and mysterious expanse that has fascinated us for centuries. But as much as we've learned about it, there are still plenty of things that we've been lied to about when it comes to space. Let's take a look at some of the biggest lies we've been told about this topic. First off, we have the idea that space is just this pristine, untouched wilderness. But that's not exactly true. We've been littering space with our debris for decades. Everything from old satellites to rocket parts. In fact, there are over 20,000 pieces of debris orbiting Earth right now, and they're causing all sorts of problems for future space missions. So if you're planning on visiting space anytime soon, watch where you go. You never know what kind of garbage might be floating around. Did you know that the sun is not actually yellow? It's green. Well, kind of. You see, scientists measure the temperature of a star by the color spectrum it emits. Cooler stars appear red, while the hottest of stars look blue. Our sun emits most of its energy at a wavelength that's close to green. But because it emits other wavelengths too, all these colors mix together, and your eyes see this vibrant mixture as white. From Earth, however, the sun looks yellow because our atmosphere is really good at scattering blue light. If our star was actually yellow, Earth would become a frozen rock, and we'd all be polar bears. Plus, the sun isn't on fire for real. It's a big ball of gas, mostly made of hydrogen and helium, and it works more like a gigantic nuclear reactor, constantly fusing hydrogen atoms to create helium inside its core. This process releases enormous amounts of energy. That's why the sun is so hot. Oh, and speaking of setting things on fire, explosions in space aren't real. Sorry, Star Wars fans, a spaceship can't go down in a violent blast because there is no air out there in space. No air means no oxygen, and no oxygen means no fire. Now, you might also think that there are too many stars in the night sky for you to count, but in fact, you can do that. According to the Yale Bright Star Catalog, there are 9,110 stars that you can see from Earth with the unaided eye. So, technically, you can count them, but I wouldn't be surprised if you lost count. And if you're worried about flying through an asteroid belt, don't be. Although it does have trillions of space rocks that range in size from space dust to a quarter of the size of the moon, they're very spread out. The asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter is 140 million miles across, which is 1.5 times the distance between Earth and the Sun. This spreads space rocks thousands of miles apart, making it almost impossible for a spacecraft to collide with one. You'll instantly freeze in space without a suit. Nope, you won't turn into a popsicle right away. It's gonna take a bit longer than that because heat and cold don't really move very quickly in the vacuum of space. But unfortunately for you, there's a bigger problem at hand. You won't be able to breathe. After just 15 seconds, your brain won't be getting enough oxygen from your blood, and you'll pass out. And then after just 2 minutes, it's curtains for the rest of your organs. So, in short, if you find yourself playing astronaut without a spacesuit, it's game over pretty quickly. Did you know that space doesn't have any temperature at all? That's because the temperature is defined by the speed at which particles move and the amount of energy they have. In the true vacuum of space, there are no particles to move around, making it temperatureless. Of course, some parts of space are really hot, like areas around stars. But the further away you get from stars, the more spread out particles are, making those areas of space pretty chilly. Number 9 is our planet's shape. No, it's not flat, but it's not a perfect sphere either. Yeah, it bulges at the equator because of our planet's wild spin. It's like Earth is doing its own little dance. And because of this bulging, launching spaceships from the equator is much easier than from the poles. Now, when it comes to sound in space, it's a bit of a tricky situation. You might think that no one can hear you scream, but that's not entirely accurate. The thing is, sound needs something to travel through, like air or water. In space, things are super spread out, so all those epic space battles and galactic explosions would be completely silent. Yet there are some places in space with enough particles for sound to travel through. For example, you can hear the black hole at the center of the Perseus Galaxy Cluster. Another myth is about zero gravity. That's not a thing. There's still some gravity hanging around the International Space Station, about 90% of what we feel on good old Earth. But astronauts get to float around because they're basically free-falling around the planet. And let's be real, Hollywood's version of space travel is not factual. Sure, orbits are a thing, but different altitudes mean different speeds, so moving from one orbit to another isn't exactly a walk in the park. You can't just push yourself in the right direction and hope for the best. You gotta take those orbital velocities into account. This reminded me of the 2013 movie Gravity and how Sandra Bullock tried to survive in space. Hollywood sure added some fuel to these myths. Yet again, who can blame them? Back in 1976, NASA's Viking 1 spacecraft snapped a photo of a curious rock formation on Mars that looked suspiciously like a face. Some folks out there claimed that it must have been proof of extraterrestrial life on the red planet, but NASA had a different take. According to the space agency, the face was nothing more than a bunch of rocks piled up in such a way that the shadows they cast created an illusion of facial features. It turns out it was just a regular hill that got a little too much credit for being photogenic. The solar system stays in place. Lie! It's zooming through space at a speed of 140 miles per second, which means that it's whizzing through the cosmos faster than a cheetah chasing its prey. It takes us 230 million years for the solar system to complete a full orbit around the Milky Way. It's a good thing it isn't getting a speeding ticket, because that would be one astronomical fine, eh? Without the sun, planets would be pretty chilly. We're talking about temperatures as low as negative 455 degrees Fahrenheit. Brr. But with the sun around, the planets get to enjoy much more livable temperatures. Of course, not all planets are created equal. Mercury, for example, is the closest to the sun. Venus, on the other hand, is farther away, but somehow manages to be even hotter than Mercury. The distance from the sun isn't the only factor that affects a planet's temperature. Other things like the planet's size and reflectivity also come into play. So Mercury being the hottest planet in our solar system is a false proposition. No, just because it's the closest one to the sun doesn't mean it's the hottest. Even though we've been deceived in some ways, that doesn't make space any less amazing. It's still a vast, beautiful, and utterly fascinating part of our universe. And there's still so much we have yet to discover. Who knows? Maybe one day we'll really discover little green people out there. Or maybe we'll find out something even more incredible. Until then, we'll just have to keep dreaming and exploring. There, you got 14 things on our list. Do you have any other space myths to debunk?
That's it for today. So hey, if you pacified your curiosity, then give the video a like and share it with your friends. Or if you want more, just click on these videos and stay on the bright side.